चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावन वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो। महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मेतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतोऽस्मि। तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणन्ति। The 88,000 of Rishi in Naimisharanya, they asked a question to Srila Suta Goswami that Sukadev Goswami was renounced. He has not attached to anyone. He, even like mad in Krishna Prem, he never stayed to any door, any grihastha, to anywhere more than 2 minutes. Never. He has not attached to any worldly thing. He had no attachment in this world, wanting nothing in this world. How he met Parikshit Maharaj and he told Srimad Bhagavatam to him, then he is telling that after Krishna, he disappeared with his all associates of Vrindavan, Mathura and Dwarka. Then Kali wanted to enter in this world. Once he was after Krishna, Parikshit was made the king of Indraprastha, and the Vajrana, what?
He was grandson of Krishna. Great grandson of Krishna.
Krishna. He was brought by Parikshit Maharaj. He was brought up. And he, Parikshit Maharaj, gave the kingdom of Mathura, Sursen Rajya, to Vajranava. He discovered the pastime places of Krishna, which had been become like dense forest. No one knowing where is Radhakund, Shyamkund, Vrindavan, Kamevan, or all bans, and where, what he has done. He discovered all this with the Sandilya Muni and other rishis. And then one day he has gone to hunter. Hunter? Okay.
Hunting.
Hunting. He went. Never killing. Only for show he is doing, because he was Kshatriya. So he became so thirsty, and he was so much tired. And he went to a rishi, Angiras, who was in very deep trance of Bhagavan Krishna. The king asked some water. Oh, I want to take water. Please give me water. I'm so thirsty. But he was in a so deep trance that he could not reply. At once he became somewhat angry. Anger takes all the intelligence and everything. It is the root of all evils. So, where is Navadvip?
Yeah.
Always become late. If any place here, near Khol, you can Mridanga come. I will punish one day. Very.
Like this.
So, what I was telling?
Anger comes
as the intelligence comes.
Don't be angry. That is why Guru tells that keep this finger out of your heart, that bag, and then chant Hare Krishna. Don't touch by this finger. It denotes, I will break your legs. I will punish you. You know that who am I? By this. False echoes. So try to take it out of that bag that is your heart. Mahaprabhu has also told, Gita has also told, Krishna told to Arjuna, krodha esha, kama esha, krodha esha, rajogun samadbhava. And it takes all the intelligence and everything. Though Parikshit Maharaj, out of anger, was pure devotee, but yet he shows, place a part of like drama, like by anger he lost his intelligence and everything. So quickly he told that, oh, I will
teach you a lesson.
No, I will give a very good garland.
Presentation.
Presentation.
Gift.
Gift. And he took a
dead snake.
Dead snake and gave. Three rounds here. And quickly he returned, but in the way he was repenting. What mistake I have done? Oh, blunder I have done. And in the meantime, a student of that rishi came at once and told that, Maharaj, when you gave dead snake in the neck of that Rishi, his son was playing anywhere on the bank of a river with so many boys, age 5 years, naked. And he heard that any king has done this. And at once he became angry and took water from the river and did Achman and told, oh, now we have kept some dogs to look after kitchen. But dogs now, very greedy, entering our
kitchen
and they want to take something
from the plate of the master.
Now these Kshatriyas, Kshatriyas means this
administrative warrior, administrative class.
They like Kshatriya. Those who are like kings, ruler, they are dogs. We Brahman made them like a doorkeeper,
watchkeeper.
But now they have entered and taking all the things which we are offered to Krishna. Oh, now they have become so desperate. I will teach a lesson to them. Attacking them, saying this, and he took water and he threw. Though, who may be anyone, he has insulted my father. not by father but Brahmanist Rishi. So this water will go to that person. And a snake, very poisonous snake, will bite him on the end of 6-7 days. And anyone cannot save him. He must die. And telling this, he began to weep. And he came to his father and saw that, oh, dead snake is really there. He too poked it and began to cry, weep so much, loudly. After some time, his trance was gone. And, oh my boy, why you are weeping so loudly? Father, see, anyone has given this dead snake and he has offended you. So I have given some Brahma Shrap. What Brahma Shrap?
Curse.
That after 7 days this snake will go and bite the king and he will die. Oh, at once he told, oh boy, you are not Brahmin. How you do it so? I am seeing that it has been done by Parikshit Maharaj. He is so pious, good king, very religious, devotee, and you have given cause to him. It seems that you are not Brahmin. You have no qualities of Brahmin. Brahmin should tolerate everything. A devotee also should tolerate everything. Don't be upset if anyone offends you or does anything. Keep quiet, like Prahlad Maharaj, Haridas Thakur. Otherwise, Krishna Prem is not so easy that in a minute you will take. You will have to tolerate. Trinadapishu is that slow. So he rebuked his son, and after that, at once he sent that person. His one student, that go at once and tell Parikshit Maharaj, he should do whatever he wants to do. 7th day, death is sure. Parikshit Maharaj heard this and became so happy, so happy. Why happy? He told that, oh, it is not Brahma Shrap, but himself Krishna has come mercifully. It is the mercy of Krishna himself. I wanted to give up this
kingdom.
World, kingdom, wife and sons and everything. Because I have played in the lap of Krishna. He has saved me, not for all these things. So now I am thinking that Krishna has come in the shape of this course. So I must at once give up all these things. He took his crown, royal dresses, at once given, his bow and arrows and everything. And quickly went on the bank of Ganges. And he began to prayopavation, means
fasting.
Not taking anything, water even, water or anything. And he was praying to Krishna, what should I do now? And knowing this thing, from all parts of our world, Vasishtha, Gautam, Vishwamitra, Harit, Deval, Asit, and all Parashar, Narad, also Narad, Vyas, and Parshuram, all prominent, Kashyap Rishi went from Caspian Sea, from Mangal Rishi, came from Mongolia. So many rishis from all over the world. Some came from Partha, you know?
Australia.
Partha, Australia also. Yeah. So from all other parts, all. Some came from Ramanakdeep?
Fiji.
So all places, all the rishis. In a moment, at that time was no discovery of wireless or
computer,
all these things.
Internet, email.
Nothing. But how they knew? And at once they quickly came no airplane, nothing like this, and more than 1 lakh, so many grihastha, so many karmi also, all assembled there. At that time there were a culture of Shabda Brahma. Shabda Brahma means word Brahma. And by this all knew at once. It is more important than today's
modern science.
Modern science is lame and quite
blind.
They cannot make a leg of an ant. Never they cannot. If the leg of ant is broken, they cannot make an ant. They cannot know what is soul here existing, but they will try to go to moon and sun and Brihaspati and here. So, at that time, science was so of high class, all assembled. A boy also came there. His name was Sukadeva Goswami, quite naked, like mad persons. Women seeing that boy, taking some
stones,
dust,
and throwing. And boy some having some
stones.
And they were falling,
throwing
to Sukadeva Goswami. But he has nothing to see. He came, and at once Narad, Vyas, and all rishis, Vasishtha also of Satyayuga, all stood up, and they welcomed. And then Parikshit Maharaj fell flat on the lotus feet of Sukadeva Goswami. And then he took him to the Vyas Ashram, and then he prayed himself. What is a duty of person who is just now dying, just ready, in a moment he will die? And also second question, that those who are not dying just now, but day or tomorrow, day after tomorrow, after 10 years, 20 years, 100 years, 100 years, 1,000 years, they must die. So what they should do? And then Parikshit Maharaj and
Sukadeva
Goswami then began to address all rishis and Parikshit Maharaj and telling Srimad Bhagavatam. So you should hear all these things from this Sanghita, Brahmi Sanghita, or what? Which Vyas have taken seen in his trance. You should. One thing I forgot to tell. One day Parikshit Maharaj, before this, he was touring in his kingdom, and he saw a cow and a bullock.
Bull.
And cow was so lean and thin. And that bull, he has only one leg and broken. His 3 legs were broken. Partly one leg was there. And a black person, like Kali, very mota taja,
fatty,
very bhayanak,
ferocious.
And he was beating him with mota danda, sometimes to cows and sometimes to that bull. And they were weeping. They were so weak that they cannot run. And he was beating. Parikshit Maharaj at once saw and became so merciful. And he took his bow and arrow. At once I will shoot you. Then that person began to do it like this. Oh, save me, save me. Who are you? Why you are doing? And he told that, who are you, cow? It seems that you are not cow or not bull. Who are you? Then cow told that, I am Prithvi. Prithvi means
earth.
And this bull is dharma.
Religion.
Now he is without legs. Only three legs have been gone and one is, and that is also broken. Dharma. Shaucha, daya, dan, and dharma. What is shauch?
Cleanliness.
Like putana, all what? Unworthy things?
Impure
things. Is the Shiva the
embodiment
of that. So all are engaged in this. There is no pavitrata, pureness. If they can take what three times shower, but yet their heart is so dirty. No dan. Dan meant donations to us. At first, after Dwapar Yug, all he used to give some big to others. No one wants to do like this. But when Kalju came, all began to do like this. Give me. Even king. I know that from India so many kings and so many presidents and so many ministers, prime ministers from all over world, they come to America and England, France, Germany, Japan to beg something. All begging, beggars. It has gone away. And satya.
Truthfulness.
Short mane?
Truthfulness.
Not duplicate. In inner heart something and outer something. Where you are going? He will tell. If he is going to west, he will tell. Oh, I am going to south, east. Where you are going? If he is going to north, he will tell?
South.
He will not disclose anything. So, everything now, jhuta lena, jhuta chabena in India. Jhuta lena, jhuta dena, jhuta chabena, jhuta everything. Everything is now
false.
Not satya anything. Cheating also, your Atma also, our Atma, always reveals. We can earn money by cheating others. Very expert in cheating. All is cheating another. All thinks that I am very intelligent, I am cheating him, and he thinks that I am cheating others. So all cheating others. The satya, daya, no
mercy.
How mercy? We are so merciful like this. Any person, especially one Muslim, he was so kind. He has kept a murgi, you know, hen, and one
cock.
Rooster.
Like bakari.
Goat,
she goat. And he used to love so much to that hen and
the goat.
After 1 year, they became so fat. Now Bakrid was coming. Bakrid, you know?
A festival
of Muslims.
Oh.
And then festival, they will cut that hen and
goat.
And now they have become so much. So he is so much kind to them and supporting and giving always and curiosity and they don't know all these things. And one day they will cut and take. Or we are so much kind like a person that any thief came in his house and he was caught handed, red-handed caught. The master of the house told, oh, don't beat him. Maromat, don't beat him. Be kind to him. Take him and you should fall in a very deep well.
Throw him.
He will automatically die. So we are so much kind like this. So everything is gone. Dharma is telling bull that all the saints nowadays reading Bhagavatam and taking so much donation for this and maintaining their
family life.
Families and testing all these things. So the essence of Srimad Bhagavat has gone away. So many renowned person have so much luxurious his house, that is, palatial buildings, that even a grihastha king has not such thing. Everything golden, his court, his bedding, his everything, his almira of gold and jewels. So what was the need of taking renounce order? And grihastha are dying, starving, not anything. Oh, ladies also like that. All their beauty by decorating their hairs.
Cosmetic.
And
lipstick.
Lipstick.
Cosmetic.
Not by brahmacharya. Oh, automatically beautiful by brahmacharya. Beauty will peep from inside. Only decorating their self. Only this, nothing. And the persons, males, always cheating others. So we are very worried for this. Then Parikshit Maharaj at once became so angry. Oh, this is Kali, and due to this it has going on. So he took his bow and arrow. Oh, I will at once kill you, shooting. Then he began to pray, why Prabhu you are doing so? We are four brothers. Satya.
Satya Saucha Daya.
Satya Yug. And Treta, Dwapar and Kali. We are four brothers. Our father had divided our kingdom for times, according to time. My three brothers, elder brothers, have tested. But now this is my period. So why you are killing me? Be kind to me. Give some places there where I can be there. Then he became happy. So don't go here and there. Only you should situate in these four things I am giving. Dyutam, Panam, Istriyam, Shuna, Jatra, Adharma Chaturvita. Where there is a dharma, that is in four things. Dutang, gambling. Panam. Panam means all kinds of
intoxications.
Wine, cigarette, churut, ganja, bhang, afim, even chai, coffee, all these things. Cigarette, bidi, or anything like this. Any kinds of dhumrapan, smoking, or taking, all these things. And third, istriyam. Those who think that all the males have been created only for our taste. They are not thinking anyone that she is my mother, she is my sister, she is my
daughter.
There you can be. And there, where always hinsa is going on.
Violence
is going on. By tan, man, bachan, by?
Body, mind and words.
Body, mind and
words.
Never we should try to give pain to others. I see that so many persons in very morning going to sea or anywhere,
fishing.
Keeping some fishing there, and killing so many fishes. I think that if anyone very stout person will go and he will tell that oh, give me your bansi, I also want to fish. And he will give that thing like ash,
hook
in his stomach, mouth. And then he should, how he will feel? So, you should go to all these places. He told that, oh, these places are very, very small. Please give me that I can somewhat go here and there. Then he told, oh, there is gold. Gold means money. You should go there. Then all things will come automatically, all Kali. Gambling, wine, and drinking all these things, slaughtering and everything, and babhichar.
Illicit relationship. Illicit relationship.
All bad things will be there. And then you can be there. And he came. And after that he went to that rishi, and after that he had karsh. So we should try so much to be careful from all five things. Otherwise, you cannot be devotees. I see that so many devotees now, lacking of all these things, association, good association, they become so weak. Those who were bona fide devotees in the time of Swamiji, now becoming so weak, they are taking ganja bhang. Oh, I am so okay. I am chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Of him, and so many
intoxicants,
so many things they are taking. They are forgotten to chant. Sometimes they can chant one or not even. So I am requesting all to be very careful for five things and try to become pure devotee. I think that Kali is also one place, very important place. They can be helped, five classes of person. But those who are Mayavadi, they cannot be helped. They are more dangerous, more dangerous. Anyone cannot help them. So try to be careful for Mayavadi, anyone. If you want to love Krishna and want to be happy forever, then don't go to Mayavadis and listen to them and follow them. Whether his father, mother, guru even, he should be given up. So five and one, this six should be given up. Then pure devotion may come and help you. Krishna will arrange for good association also. So then he began to tell, then he told something for real bhakti and something to be virakta hone ke liye sansar se.
Detached from material existence.
That world is what? Like?
Dream.
Illusion. Not dream. Illusion.
Very sufferingful.
Full of misery.
Full of miseries. To realize this. So he began to tell Dhruva Charitra, Ajamil Charitra, Prahlad Charitra, Kapil Devhuti Shambhat,
Puranjan,
and then Chitraketu Maharaj Upakhyan, Ambarish Maharaj, all. Why? That they will hear all these things. Also Ramacharitra, that is Raman, and Jai Vijay, like Hiranyakashipu Hiranyaksha. Also all these things. Only to virakti sansarse hai.
To become detached from material existence.
And he told 10th canto for love and affection to attain. Braj prem to be. And that was nigam kalpatarur galitana phalam. So both should be taken. If you are not qualified so much, then we will have to go first from one canto to ninth. And then we will realize that world is like dream. The relations are dream-like. We cannot attain happiness. And then a detachment will come. But it cannot come automatically. By chanting, remembering, doing some devotional services, then it will come. And it will be forever. Otherwise, by hearing these things, it may be that for temporary vairagya will come, but it will not be
permanent.
Durable.
Permanent.
Permanent. So, we should always hear Harikatha, pastimes of Krishna, very strongly. That Vyas, in his last days, he received from Narada. And he did Srimad Bhagavatam. So, in all these pastimes of devotees, like Dhruva, Prahlad, there are some essence to be taken. Somewhat Mishra Bhakti.
Mixed.
Some mixed with karma, something jnana. Then jnana bhakti, then pure bhakti, and then very pure bhakti up to Vaikunth, and then Dwarka bhakti, and then Braj bhakti. In Braj bhakti also, sakya bhava, friendship, then Vatsalya, and moreover, Gopi mood, gopis serving to Krishna. Among all the gopis, four, Swapaksha, Vipaksha,
Tatastha,
and Suhi. And among them, Srimati Radhika is more prominent. She is the Parashakti, Antaranga Shakti, Swarup Shakti of Krishna. No
difference
between them. So first we will come from Dhruva. Oh, you can tell some Dhruva. Charitra. Can you? Go on. Very boldly. Where is speaker?
There.
From there.
So, Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Shumate Gaurgavim Samadhi. Namo Vishnu Padaya Radhikaye Priyatmane Sri Srimad Bhakti Namane. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasadaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Namane Swami Namane Namane Gauravana Vicharaya Vishesh.
Oh, I have done pranam for all, so quickly you should go on. यहाँ पर थोड़ा सा जगह छोड़ो जैसे कोई आएगा तो यहाँ से बोल दे
अभी
लोग भर लेते ना भी बैठो कल से ऐसा
कौन
डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम
ध्रुव महाराज एट अ वेरी यंग एज ही वांटेड टू सिट ऑन द lap of his father. His father's name was
Uttanapada.
And his stepmother, whose name was
Suruchi.
Suruchi, she said to Dhruva that actually you're not qualified to sit on the lap of the king, Uttanapada. That for you to be qualified, that you have to be born from my womb, and then you'll be able to sit on the lap. So then Dhruva, he was a Kshatriya, he was very, very hurt by this. He took it as a great insult. So he went to his mother, whose name was Suniti, and he asked his mother, how is it that I can get a kingdom which is greater than my father's kingdom. So then Suniti, she told him that I've heard that If you go and you worship Lord Vishnu, then he can fulfill your desire. So he asked, where can I find Lord Vishnu? And she told him that if you go to the forest, I've heard that you can find him in the forest. So these two ladies, Suruchi and Suniti, their names have significance. Suruchi means that one who has great taste, but her taste is for material sense enjoyment. And Suniti means one who is taken to the path of regulated spiritual life. So she gave Dhruva Maharaj this advice that you should go to the forest and perform austerities. So Dhruva Maharaj, he went to the forest and he was very determined to perform his austerities. And going there, then Narada Muni, he appeared on the scene. And Narada Muni, he tested Dhruva Maharaj. Because Dhruva, he was very determined that he must get this kingdom. And Narada Muni came and he asked, oh, but you're such a young boy, you're only 5 years old, and you're the son of a king, you're a very tender young boy, why are you going through all these, why do you want to have such a kingdom? Why do you want to undergo such austerity? And Dhruva Maharaj, he was very determined, and he just told Narada Muni that, if you can help me, then please, you can give me instruction. Also, he told him that, I know that your instructions to me to not take this to heart, what my father's told me, I know that this is true. But because I'm a Kshatriya, I'm a son of a king, then it's very difficult for me to follow such instructions. So if you can help me and give me such instructions, how I can get such a kingdom, which is greater than my father's, then please help me. So then Narada Muni, he saw that this boy is very determined. Only 5 years old, he's left home, he's gone in the middle of the forest, where so many animals, lions, tigers, snakes, etc. But he's completely undaunted, he's just fixed on his goal. So Dhruva Maharaj is teaching here that one who takes the spiritual path, then one has to be very determined. Ekeha. In Bhagavad Gita, that is there, Ekeha Kuru Nandana. That one who's Bhavashakahiran Tischa, one who's many branch, going for different material desires, then one cannot take your spiritual path. So even though Dhruva Maharaj, his motivation was materially tinged, but he had this qualification of determination and also honesty. He was honest with Narada Muni. So Narada Muni, seeing this qualification in Dhruva Maharaj, then he gave him mantra. By which he could attain his goal. So then Dhruva Maharaj, he started to chant the mantra which was given by Narada Muni. And let's explain that, the details I am forgetting.
Go on.
So he explained that, it's explained in Srimad Bhagavatam that first he was only taken
some dry fruit, vegetables,
leaves. Fruits or leaves?
Fruits or leaves.
He was only taking fruits or leaves
interval of 4 or 5 days.
For a period of 4 or 5 days. And then after that, then he stopped taking the leaves, and then he just started to take water for a period of
7 days after he used to take water.
Every 7 days, then he would take some water. Then after that, he stopped taking water, and then he just started to live on the air. And he would breathe every
15 days.
Every 15 days. So,
then he gave up breathing.
And then he came in trance. Totally then, stopping air, water, all things. And then Brahma was disturbed. All demigods were disturbed. And then Narayan himself came in the four armed Sankh Chakra Gada Padma, all taking. After a moment, he came out from his heart and he became so
restless.
And he opened his eyes and he saw that, oh, he's there. And Krishna, that is Narayan, gave him bad injection that for 36,000 of years, you will be the king, monarch of the whole world. And telling at once quickly disappeared. Oh, what blunder I've done. Oh, there was Chintamani. Chinta means
Touchstone.
And I missed it. And I collected only some broken pieces of glass. And then he began to weep so loudly. But Narayan has disappeared, nothing to do. At once his father came. Mother came and all came and took them to kingdom and they gave kingdom to him. And he was the ruler for 36,000 of years. What is the purpose in this? He has so many beautiful wives, sons and grandsons, very beautiful and strong. He has full of his khajana,
treasure
was full of gold and everything. Everything in life he has attained, but he was not happy. Without bhakti, he cannot be happy. He left at once, and at the same time death came, and he kept his fate on the
head of death.
Head of that death, and quickly went to Haridham, that is Dhruva Lok. If anyone is not following the rules and regulations and teachings of Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, and Ved Upanishad, and want to test all these things, worldly desires, then they are like donkey, no intelligence at all. So Sukadeva Goswami told this to Parikshit Maharaj, don't be like this. You are so lucky that you have left all these things. So we should take lesson from Dhruva. In 33,000 years he was monarch, having everything that we want, more than Indra, he has had everything. But he was not pleased by this. So you should know that anyone by money, by beautiful sons and daughters and wives, anyone cannot be happy. Anyone can be happy only by chanting, remembering the name of Krishna, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam. He did also like that. That is why he went to that dham. I missed to say one thing today I wanted to tell you. I told about Guru yesterday, that a Guru like Narad and disciple like Vyas. A Guru like Vyas and disciple like Sukadeva Goswami. Not like a Guru like Baladev Prabhu, it is all right. But not disciple like Lomaharshan Sutta. Then a bona fide guru can be served. I've told you any time that there was also a very strong devotee. His name was अरे वो नाम तो भूल ही जाच्छे अरे अर्जुन के रिवाइव मरा गया
कर्ण
और एक जो मारा गया कृष्ण ने चक्र से
मारा
एकलव्य सो मेनी आई हैव सीन दैट सो मेनी डिवोटीज In the line of Swamiji, they gave name to their
disciples
Ekalabhya, Ekalabhya Maharaj. And they think that, oh, very good name. I want to tell you that if you have some intelligence, we should try to think whether Ekalabhya was bona fide disciple or not. He must be, because his guru told that, at once you should give me your right thumb. And he at once gave. So why not very qualified devotee? He must be. But we should see, we should judge it deeply. First he went to Dronacharya. Oh Gurudev, I am accepting you, my Gurudev. Why you are accepting me? I want to learn archery. Why you want? Because I want to defeat Krishna and Arjuna. Why you want to defeat? Because Krishna and Arjuna are not good persons. They cheat others. Always, he is not equal to all. Sometimes he takes
part.
Side of
devotees, not to all. Why he does? So I want to defeat Krishna also, Arjuna. I want to kill Arjuna also. He told that, I cannot do. You can go to another guru. Those who have a mood like this,
envy.
I cannot teach. You are not qualified to be admitted in my school. Then he went and he began to learn all these things, keeping a statue of Dronacharya. And he became in some days very expert. One day, Dronacharya, with all Kauravas and Pandavas, all disciples, Arjun, Bhim, Nakul, Sahadev, Duryodhana, they were going in a forest. Dronacharya wanted to test all. In the meantime, a dog was pursuing him and he began to bark at once. At once they saw that he was barking, but now he has stopped, he is not barking. Why not? They saw that some
arrows
have
filled his mouth.
And he cannot speak. He cannot bark. Who did it? No injury, nothing anywhere, but he cannot shout, he cannot bark. Oh, who has done this miracle? Any expert archer. So, from what side
arrows
coming, and they followed, and they saw a very black, young person. Who are you? Oh, he did pranam to Dronacharya. And Dronacharya asked, who are you? I am Ekalabhya, your disciple. Oh, you are my disciple. How you become so expert? I refused you to take as a disciple. He told that. I made your statue. And here thinking that you are my guru, I am practicing. Oh. Have you paid me?
Guru Dakshina?
No, I have never paid. But I want to pay. Now you are expert, you should pay Guru Dakshina. Oh, what you like? Oh, I like your this thumb, right thumb. Why? He did not told anything. That why? But he at once took his sword and at once cut it and gave Dakshina. Blood was coming. After that, Dronacharya returned, but why he can't? Because he knows his heart. He was friend of Duryodhan, Karna, Shakuni, you know, Kali himself, Shakuni. giving bad advices and helping them. So once it became that he wanted to kill Arjun and also fighting with Krishna, then Krishna took his chakra and at once
cut off his head.
Dangerous person. So you should know he was not Guru. We should try to follow what our Gurudev wants. Then disciple. But Gurudev is telling another thing, one thing, and he is doing another thing, not obeying, disobeying always, not knowing what is the heart of my Gurudev, then actually he is not disciple. Never he can be. So I see, in this Kali Yuga, there are so many lakhs and lakh disciples, but very rare disciple qualified. There was a disciple who that world has recognized him. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamahiyam Dadati. He has fulfilled all the desires of his Gurudev. He knew the heart of his Gurudev. Who was Gurudev? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. He had come to propagate Raganuga Bhakti and to relish pure praying of Srimati Radhika. So he knew the heart of his Gurudev and he expressed in Ujjwal Nilmani Bhakti Swami Sindhu and so many books. So we should try to be like that, to know what is what my Gurudev wants, what is the desire of my Gurudev. Can you say that what is the desire of any bona fide guru? He has no any desire. Oh, bring so much gold to me. Money, I have so many projects. I have a project for 10 crores of dollars or 1,000 millions of dollars. I have project. So you should, what you can give. Don't try to give any farthing, pence or farthing to your wives, children, and nothing. Give all things to me. I will fulfill my project. He is not Guru. And those who are not in thinking all these things, and they are following that unqualified Guru, both andhai jathandhai upaniyamana, they will go to hell, both. Guru will fall first and then his shish also fall. Both will fall. So we should try to be careful. Also, you know, Karna, brother of Pandavas, elder, he went to Parshuram. He first went to Dronacharya, but Dronacharya refused. Then he went to Parshuram. Incarnation of Krishna, God. And he went there. And he became a Brahmin boy. He told that I am Brahmin. I have come to know all the Brahma Vidya with archery and all Vidya. He did not told that I have come only to
defeat Arjuna.
No.
Only to learn archery.
Only to archery. He told Brahma Vidya also. Archery also, all kinds of vidya. Parshuram saw that, he is very in serving mood. And from that day, he took
sacred sets
he was taking and serving his Gurudev. Very, very strongly he was serving. One day, and he began to teach him archery, Brahma Vidya and all, everything. One day, Parshuram was sleeping, keeping his head on the lap of Karna. And an insect, very powerful.
Snake. Not snake.
Bajrakeet.
Not a snake.
Scorpion.
What?
Scorpion.
Scorn? Caspian? No.
He's telling snake, but it's not snake.
No. Very powerful, any insect.
Termit or something.
Scorpion. That is called Bajrakeet.
Scorpion.
Not scorpion.
No, like a termite.
And he came at once and he began to cut.
Make a hole.
He made a hole in the jangha.
Thigh
of
Karas.
And he was so patient that, oh, my Gurudev may
wake up.
So he was. Oh, very patiently he was bearing all these things. Blood so much came that his face was
covered, sweating,
touched by that, and oh, from where it is coming? What is this? And there's blood and blood. Oh, who are you? I know that now I have known that you are not Brahmin boy. Who are you? You must be Kshatriya. What is your name? Then he told his actual name. He became so fearful. I will at once cause you, tell what is the truth. Then he told that I have come to you. I am Karna, Aradheya, son of any
Adhirat.
And I have come to you to learn archery. Why? Oh, to defeat my rival.
Rival is Arjuna.
Then he told, yes, you have served me so much. I have given you all Brahma Vidya and Brahmastra and all kinds of archery and Brahma Vidya also. But when a time will come, next time, you will forget. Now, you should remember all these things, it is all right. But when you will need it, you will forget all these things. When he was returned, and in Mahabharata they were fighting with Arjuna and Karna, and at the very time when both were fighting, at once he forget all these things. His chariots went on earth, and he could not do. And then Arjun quickly killed him. So don't be a disciple like Karna. Be what? What you are inner, outer you should be same. Not policy, duplicacy with Gurudev. Not, don't look towards the pocket of your Gurudev. Gurudev, really Gurudev qualified, they have no any pocket.
Yeah, yes.
If they are pockets, 3, 4, 5, 6, then he is not actually Guru.
To put hearts.
But if any Gurudev has pocket to keep very smooth and sweet hearts in their pocket, he may have. But not worldly things. If he is so attached, then he is not really Gurudev. Swamiji came to this world, who are hippie, who are not so much, they were all like ignorant. He came and he took all these hearts, whether they are bad or, and he made them smooth, very sweet, and keep in his pocket. So Vaishnavas are like that. Try to be very obedient, honoring all devotees, not quarreling, and so much strong in Krishna faith, Guru Gauranga serving. Then you are hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, otherwise taking by this and giving by this. Don't do. Gaur Premanande.
Hare Hare. Guru, one might say that he gave the thumb and that's a bona fide disciple. Other people might say, so what would your answer to that?
What I could
he ask. Says that Ekalokya, people may argue he gave his thumb as Dakshina, so he is bona fide.
No.
What would you say to that?
But
argument?
He took it only for that he cannot
so
make good he punished him.
But why did Ekalokya give so readily his thumb?
Giving is not that thing. He gave. But he could not follow his Gurudev. He told that, give me that anger and lust and all other things. He wanted. Infinite, you should give up envy and all. He could not give. Only he used to give some worldly things. So those who are giving worldly things, donations and all these things, they are really not. But one who gives his heart fully and know the wishes of Gurudev and falling, they are disciple true. So he cut the finger, only that he could not fight with her. Mahamantra.
Just
after you should.
In 5 minutes, we have some bhajan and we'll get ready.
So you should do bhajan.
Doing your drama?
But I'm coming just now. Come on.
Everybody, can please move over to this side of the temple room. We're going to have
I'm just coming.
Going to the bathroom. We're going to have the drama here.